Good morning, I'm Marek Minakowski. I'm chief scientist at Onet.pl, and my job is to tell the future. And it is a tough job, as you can see. It's tough because we are bombarded every day with products and services, let's call them machines, which are awesome, great, fantastic, new, revolutionary, groundbreaking, breathtaking. We cannot see the forest for trees. This 20th century quotation is not good. It doesn't work. We need something better, some maybe 19th century wisdom. Yes, dear Watson, you're right. It's deduction. It's elementary, dear Watson. So let's make a deduction. To have a deduction, we first need some assumptions. And the first assumption is that the machines have great, enormous storage. They store more and more information every day. It's growing indefinitely. Also, the computing power is growing very fast, exponentially according to the Moore's law. Every 2 years, the number of chips doubles. The input devices, the sensors, are collecting information from everywhere very fast with some help of the government. On the other hand, this is how our thinking device looked like almost 2 centuries ago. Do you think anything changed? Nothing. The same hardware, the same computing power, the same input devices, eyes, ears, hands, and so on. Even the same working memory, this magic 7 objects that we can store. Nothing changes at all. So we can now draw an equation and state our first theorem. So what the total amount of information that is produced by the machine world for the human world is what we can really absorb, what we can understand, take in, and the rest is junk, trash, waste, and so on. So having said this, we can now jump to another conclusion. Very striking, that actually everything that is delivered to us humans and that will be delivered in future centuries will be constant because our devices, our hardware is not changing, and the amount of hours is also not changing. For example, in Poland, the number of people is not actually growing. So taking some other assumption, we can say that virtually, it is constant within the order of magnitude. So now we need another observation. That for centuries, humans are either pulling information from something or are being pushed by some information. For instance, 10,000 years ago, you could go to some holy man and ask, when it will rain at last? We are dying. Or clouds, yes, rain. 200 years ago, you could pull information from some wise books that would tell you everything. For instance, how should you wash your skirt? Or you were pushed by information in newspapers. It was a quite new invention 200 years ago. For instance, the Times was circulating 7,000 copies in some 1810. Now, we either pull the information from some holy Google that will answer everything we ask it, or we are being pushed by information at some Facebook or so. So now let's go back to the question. How internet will look like in next 200 years ago? How the media world will look like. And the correct answer is that it will actually not change at all. Because we will not be able to consume more information than we are now. Also, our main ways of obtaining information will be also the same because they are defined by the world, by how we are built. So, what will be? We will be either asking some crystal ball, oh dear ball, tell me which dress should I put this evening, and it will give good answer, of course. Or there will be some perfect secretary who will first protect us from the flood of information, because machines will be producing more and more and more and more and more and more information. But we are not able to take in more than we are taking already now. So, if you should take home something, some idea worth spreading, the idea is that there will be some perfect secretary with crystal balls, ball. Still. Yes, and the whole energy, the whole development will go in just being better, smoother, wiser, more pleasant, and so on and so forth. And that's the main direction of the development next 200 years or so. Thank you very much.
I think I need one of those perfect secretaries. If our brains really are able to, you know, take a certain amount of information, which of course it's, I mean, anyone who works with information, it's obvious. The next question is, what happens to all this incredible amount of data that's being produced and that is going to continue being produced? And it's going to be produced at an ever increasing rate, we can assume. Is there an army of experts who are digesting it and spitting out the important bits? Or is it just all getting stored on, you know, big storage devices somewhere to be maybe accessed in the future at some stage? Or is it all just going off into the ether and people are being paid to produce it with kind of not a lot to show for it?
Actually, the number of people in the mankind as such all over the earth will not grow indefinitely. So the number of brains working with this information will also not grow. So my idea is that actually every this information produced will be stored in these machine tanks inside. So we will not be able to access it. In the future, we will not be able to check whether Google and Facebook and so are correct or not. So far now, we are not actually know whether Google's algorithm work well or not. Maybe they, engineers at Google, know, but I suppose most of them also don't know. The same with Facebook, it's the same campus in the US.
Cool. Thank you.